At this time, we just pray that throughout all of these sessions, that your presence definitely has been in the midst. Now, this time, Father, as we look at the gospel of health, we ask for the presence of your Holy Spirit. We want to hear what the chief physician has to say regarding to how to preserve these physical bodies in such of a degree and such of a state that our minds might be clear and we might be able to discern the voice of the living God. We thank you for this. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So these meetings that we're giving are entitled the Gospel of Health series. And as I told everybody that came in, we have recorded these on DVDs. There are 10 wonderful series here. And we will have all this information at our table once we set it up. We have books of this nature here. Those who are not familiar with our program on different diseases, on diabetes or cancer, these are what we call how-to programs. These are programs that tells you step by step how to preserve your health. And with these DVDs, and there's much more. Then we have an educational cookbook. We call it educational cookbook because it's more than all of our beautiful recipes, but it gives you plans, menu plans, tell you how to teach and hygienes and et cetera. It's called From Sad to Glad, SAD, Standard American Diet to the God's Life Activating Diet, which we find in Genesis chapter 1:29 and Genesis chapter 3:18. Now, those who are truly serious because of their relationship to God as being Christians, especially if you're a Seventh-day Adventist Christian, every member of the church should be a medical missionary. So some people cannot come. We run a school like Harlan. We train mainly gospel medical missionary. But this is a home study course. We have, you know, you can get more information. We can show you how it looks. 20 professional DVDs that we produce that you can take this course in your own home. You turn in, there's exams after every module. There's 7 modules here. You turn in your exams. And when you finish, you get a certificate. Then you can qualify for a 1-month internship at our Lifestyle Center. So these are just some resource information. So this morning, you have your medical books this afternoon? Where's your medical books? That's sharp. Medical book. You see, the title of this family retreat is called Repair of the Breach. I want you to keep that in mind, Repair of the Breach. Because not only there's been a breach in our spiritual life, there's been a breach in our physical life. Now, the reason I'm saying that, those who probably heard me before, maybe not, but it's just worth, because it's always good to just share your experience. Those who might have heard my testimony, like I used to be in professional sports, and a 10-year battle with arthritis stopped my career as a basketball player. And so from the age of 17 to 27, I suffered with crippling arthritis. It started with bursitis, ended to what we call arthritis, then moving into rheumatoid, which is an autoimmune condition. From 17 to 27, excruciating pain. I played exceptionally well. In another month, I'd be 63. And I stand here. I know when we got up and started walking at 5:30. Anybody was out there at 5:30 this morning? None of you? Okay. That's one brother. Okay. Okay. I just want to check. But anyways, I understand. You should just came out and walk with us. You need a rest. But my point is this. I used to be able to predict the weather. Anybody with arthritis know, understand what I'm talking about. When it rain, when it snow, whatever. Because of the ions, my joints just go into inflammatory reaction. How old was I when I had it? 17 till I was 27. And I remember my doctor telling me, he said, you know, when I was playing in school, and he said, you know, you play exceptionally well, but it is impossible for you or anybody to overcome arthritis. And he said, and the reason, because there's really no known cause for it. I want you to follow me now. There's no known cause for it or remedy. Now, I want you to listen to this. Now, you've probably been told, if anybody is sitting with a sickness, understand, your doctor tell you maybe there's no known cause. But at the same time, they will prescribe a drug for something that they don't understand. Now, maybe you all can help me with that. Now, follow me now. I was not a Christian at that time, though I believe in God. I was not a member of a church. My passion was to be rich and famous. My wife and I are from Chicago. I wanted to be one of the greatest basketball players, came out of Chicago during my time. I was on my way to do that, and my mother had a simple prayer. God, save the boy. That's all she prayed. And God, I'm standing here today because of that prayer. Why? Because God answered my mother's prayer. How did he do that? He moved arthritis into my life. Arthritis became my roommate. I don't know if you understand that. Because my passion was to be great. I had long legs, long fingers. I can jump, skip, run, etc. And so God said, I'm going to hit him in his glory. I'm going to lay his glory to dust. When you're going through that, if you don't know God, you don't know what's going on. But as you reflect, I thank God for arthritis. I don't know if you understand that. Because I'd rather have the Lord than be rich and famous, because I know I'm going to walk on that goal anyway. All right, follow me now. Okay. So I start reading the Word of God. So the doctor said there was no known cause and cure. I'm going to share this with you, then I'm going to do a simple demonstration with you. Proverbs, you can take these scriptures now. Proverbs 26:2. Notice what the Bible says. It says, the curse causeless shall not come. Did you hear that? Now the doctor said, the curse, Proverbs 26:2. The curse causeless shall not come. For every curse, there's a cause. Now look at that word curse. Don't let that word curse scare you. In Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15, this is what God said. If you do not diligently hearken to my voice, will do that which is right in my sight, keep my statute, my commandment, all these curses should come upon thee. Follow me now. Then you pick up in Deuteronomy 28, verse 22, 25, 27, 35, just read the whole chapter. And then he said, I'm going to smite you with consumption, with inflammation. What is consumption within the medical community? It's tuberculosis. Keep that in mind. So now follow me. Why do the curses come? Based on what God, the why? Because of disobedience. Keep that in mind. All right, follow me. I don't want you to go ahead of me. I don't want to put nobody on the guilt trip, but this is a factual situation if you're going to deal with your health. So the doctor said there's no known cause for arthritis. There's no remedy for it, but take these drugs. I took them for 10 years. But then when I picked up the medical book, not knowing that God was going to take me on a journey that was going to impact my life, not only spiritually, but physically and mentally. Because of my reckless life, I burnt out a lot of brain cells. And you cannot replace brain cells. And by me standing here at the age of 62, going on 63, just with a memory, is the power of God. Amen. To use what was left of my brain cells. To develop, are you listening to me? Okay, so therefore I can hear his voice and I can just walk myself into his arms. Are you following me? So God was cleansing my body to get my brain clear so my mind can be able to hear his voice. And then I became a Christian. My life began to change before I became a Christian. So when people ask me, why you do these things because you're a Seventh-day Adventist? I say, I do this because I'm in love with Jesus. Because this was written 6,000 years ago. Are you with me? It's just so providentially that the Seventh-day Adventist Church been entrusted with these truths, and yet all don't believe them. Are you with me, ladies and gentlemen? So when you say, person, well, that person don't do that, I said, that's not my business. What's your business? I'm doing it because I love the Lord. I just want to encourage my brother and sister. Listen to me now. Follow me. So I went into the Bible. Some heard this. So I began to open up the Word of God. Began to open up this word. Because I discover here in the book of Psalms 103, know ye that the Lord, he is God, he has made us, and not we ourselves, we are his what? And the sheep. Now God, who made us? Who made us? Now either you believe you came from a single cell of amoeba or a monkey, but I don't believe that. God made us. Now how did he make us? How did he make us? In his image. How did he do that? He condescended, and did, what did he do when he stooped down, sister? Moses out of what? Out of dust. Dust we are. Out of dust, my. He took that dirt. All right? As he took that dirt, I want you to follow me now. As he took that dirt, he formed it into a biochemical organism. Now, when he formed that man, Adam, out of that dirt, he was inanimated. That means there was no life in him. So what did God do? What was that breath of life? What was it? The Spirit. His Spirit. Now, if you will, I'm going to take it a step further. It was his Spirit, but it was his life. Psalm 27:1. It was his life. John chapter 1. In him is life and light. When God breathed the breath of life into Adam, he put his life into that dirt. Therefore, Adam received a life that was measured with the life of his creator. That means God created Adam to live forever. Are you listening to me? Now follow me. I'm going somewhere dealing with health. So since that is the case, that when God put his life into Adam and life, Adam became a living soul, 60,000 blood vessels kicked in. Now, when I mean 60,000 blood vessels kicked in, if you take your blood vessels, that means your capillaries, your veins, and your arteries, you might know this, and put them in a straight line, it will go around the Earth equator 2.5 times. That's your blood vessel in this young man and you and I. Now, listen to me. 60,000 miles of blood vessels going around the Earth equator 2.5 times. The red blood cell traveling in a single file through 60,000 miles of blood vessel at a speed of 43.5 miles an hour. Did you hear what I just said? You sitting here, while you sitting here, listening to me, while I'm standing here sharing, there's 60,000 miles of blood vessel that my body is comprised of, and therefore the red blood cell making their way around these through these 60,000 miles of blood vessels at a speed of 43.5 miles an hour. And we don't even feel the pressure until we mess up. Are you following me? Now follow me. Adam, as long as Adam stayed connected with the source, because God is the manufacturer of this body. And every product comes with an owner's manual. And the owner's manual tells you how to maintain the product. So when Adam was created, he was created with a warranty, a lifetime warranty. It's not like my Dell computer with 2 years. But listen, the point is this. Every manufacturer stands behind its product and its warranty. If you take care of that product according to the specification in the owner's manual, the manufacturer will take care of it. But if I take my Dell computer under warranty and throw it against the wall, then call Dell and say, my Dell computer don't work. You said you guarantee it. So what do? I threw it against the wall. Will they stand behind it? Now, with Dell, one time my computer malfunctioned and we called Dell. And they used to have 1-800 numbers, but now they put email there. See, God does not have 1-800 numbers. He doesn't have email. He has what we call kneemail. So when you start, when your body starts malfunctioning, you kneemail, then you text God with prayer. Are you with me? Now, God does not release himself. He stands behind his product. So follow me now. With arthritis, same with Adam. Adam disconnected himself. So therefore, listen, disease comes about as a result of Adam being separated from God. If there was no sin, there would be no cancer. If there was no sin, there would be no high blood pressure. If there was no sin, there would be no diabetes. Do you believe that? Mm-hmm. I believe that. Now, that doesn't mean I work with a young child less than 3 years old with lung cancer. Did he smoke? No. It's the same with this blind man that Jesus healed. You remember that? It says, who sinned? Did he sin? No. Did the mother sin? No. Father sin? No. But it came for God's glory. So if Adam had not sinned, there would never have been any sickness. Are you following me? So the point is this, is that if we're going to restore our health, preserve our health, based on that, then we got to reconnect with the source of health. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. I'm going somewhere with that. Because when people come to me with certain specific condition like high blood pressure, and they know that I'm into natural health, what they're asking me, they're not asking for me to show them how to make changes. They're asking me for a nutraceutical. They're asking me for an herb or some juicing. They're not asking me to help them to learn how to make changes. Are you with me? What they want is a nutraceutical in place of a pharmaceutical. That's what our mindset. But that's not the way God operates, per se. Now, I'm going to be doing a program on God's pharmacy. You probably saw it in your bulletin. God's pharmacy is a natural remedy. I'm going to be showing how to use potatoes and cabbage and all of that. But the point is that health is not predicated upon taking cabbage juice. It only system. Health is based on connecting back to the source. Now, follow. Someone read for me, then we're going to do this demonstration. Someone read for me Psalms 11, verse 3. Psalms 11, verse 3. Read that for me, real quick, in your medical book. Psalms 11, verse 3. Psalms 11. Psalms 11. Okay, you got it ready.
What can the righteous do?
Keep that in mind. I want you to follow me. Stay with me. This is going to be nice and sweet here. Talking about health. If the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? Righteous foundation. So there must be a foundation in which righteousness is based on. Follow me? Now, I must go to the Bible to find out. In the book of 1 John, chapter 5, I believe, verse 17, it says, all unrighteousness is sin. All unrighteousness is sin. Keep this in mind now. All unrighteousness is sin. So if unrighteousness is sin, what is sin? 1 John 3, 4, very basic. Sin is transgressing the law. So unrighteousness is breaking the law. Is that all right to say that? Righteousness would be obeying the law. It, follow my thinking now. Therefore, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? So if you remove the law, there is no foundation for righteousness. Righteousness is obedience. If you remove the law, there can be no righteousness. Is that all right? Righteousness, we don't keep the law to be saved. The law points us how to be saved. But the law is the very foundation of righteousness. Now, as it is in the spiritual, so it is in the physical. Now, listen. I'm going to share something with you. Let's go back to this. There's a wonderful book called Counsels on Diets and Food. It's a compilation, but notice what it says. There are many ways of practicing the healing art, but there's only one way that heaven's approved. Now, God did not leave us to guesstimate the way. I thank God for that, because everybody's looking for different ways to get well. Now, notice what God described here. God's remedies are the what? Simple agency of nature. They will not tax or debilitate the system through their powerful property. Notice pure air, water, cleanliness, proper diet, purity of life, firm trust in God are remedies for the want of which what? Thousands are dying. Yet these remedies are what? Going out of date because their skillful use requires what? That people do not appreciate. It's easy to take a pill than get up at 5:30 in the morning to go walking. It's easy to take a pill than go to bed at 9 p.m. instead of 1 o'clock at night. It's easier to take a pill than deal with your stress than to turn your stressful life over to God. It's easy to take a pill, even though you got to drink water, you might drink orange juice instead of drinking water. Follow me now. Follow me. Here we find these principles that you and I are familiar with. They are the foundation of health. If these laws are destroyed, there can be no remedy for health. Are you listening to me? Psalms 11. If the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? If the law is done away with, how can I deal with diabetes? How can I deal with arthritis? Because we're going to give you a definition here in a moment. Now, I know you're trying to write those down, but you got them all on this sheet of paper here, and you just need to write the scripture. If you have a website, internet, I will give you my website. And you can download this free. Psalms 11:3, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? Now, follow me. I'm going to take you to one of the most profound definition that is written anywhere in the world that was inspired by God, written by a woman that had fourth grade education. Come from a book called what? Ministry of Healing. Notice what it says here. Read this with me, please. Disease is an effort of nature to free the system from conditions that result from the violation of the laws of health. Now, I'm coming to the point because we're going to do a closing little example of this. The foundation of our health is based on law. It takes grace to keep the Ten Commandments. It takes grace to keep the laws of health. Did you know that? Why, Jackson? Because the same God that wrote the Ten Commandments wrote these laws on every nerve, every fiber. Huh? Did you know that? Every nerve. Now, what I want to do, my wife said my time is out, so it's lunchtime, right? Okay. Now, let me, is someone here, I'm going to give a demonstration here. Now, before you raise your hand, listen what I'm going to do. I need someone in here, an adult, who has a physical sickness. I don't want a person with a headache or back pain, toothache or cramps. I'm talking about whether you got diabetes, arthritis, cancer, high blood pressure. Is anyone in here sitting in here with that? And I want to show you how we're going to go to the law and reveal to you the cause of your problem. Anybody want to come up here and we'll show you this? And the fact is, each one of us in here has this sheet of paper, and you need to be taking inventory of which one of these doctors you need to spend time with. Do I have, now, you're my ninth group, and I never had any problem with my first eight group. All right, come on up. You able to stand for about a few moments? All right. You stand right here. We're going to talk about, what is your name, my dear?
Yolanda.
Yolanda, where are you from?
New York.
Are these your children?
These two are my children, my husband.
All right, praise God. Now, anything I do to Yolanda, don't hold me responsible for this. I'm just kidding. What part of New York, Yolanda?
Upstate, by
all right. Danville. Where are you originally from? Okay. Espanol.
That's what you were looking for.
Not really. I got daughters from Puerto Rico. All right. Listen to me. How long you've had arthritis?
About 3 years.
3 years, huh? How you know you have arthritis?
It hurts.
Anything can hurt, that means arthritis. Okay.
No, it only hurts. And I had an accident and I had a...
So you had it from accident.
Here.
Now, it's come from surgery. Now, I'm going to tell you, I'll help you, but I really want where it didn't start with surgery. Yours did not. Yours started with surgery, right? A trauma.
I'm not with the trauma, probably. Yeah.
Because it's an accident, it will cause arthritis. Now, lifestyle causes arthritis. So, do you still want me to talk to you about it and see?
Yeah.
Huh? Okay. Now, did you hear my story about arthritis? Did I tell you what caused it?
No.
All right, that's what we're going to do. Let me share this with you. Yolanda, right? Now, if you have a condition, or if you know anybody with a condition, whether diabetes, arthritis, or cancer, you follow the same format. Remember, disease is an effort of nature to free the system of condition that results from the violation of the laws of health. Proverbs 26:2, the curse causeless should not come. That means for every curse, let's use another word. For every effect, there's a cause. Or for every symptom. That means if I had diabetes or cancer, that is the effect, not the cause.
Correct.
All right? Another passage of scripture, Job 29:16. The cause I knew not, I searched it out. Now, if I'm going to find out what is continued contributing to my condition outside of accident, this is why it's very unique, because my condition did not come as a result of accident. It came as a result of lifestyle. Now, because she's up here, let me tell you how arthritis takes place based on what her situation is. The word arthritis, you know what it means, right? You know what arthritis means? Anybody know what it means? All right, arthritis comes from, there's two words, athron, A-T-H-R-O-N, athron. Athron meaning joints. It is like the Bible said in Colossians, our bodies are held together jointly. Itis, every time you see the word itis in anything, that's inflammation. So arthritis means inflammation of the joint. That's inflammatory, that's what produced the pain. I had arthritis throughout my body, my fingers, broken fingers, knees, ankles, back, you name it. Systemic pain, excruciating pain. In order for me to play basketball, I had to take ultrasound treatment. My ankles had to be frozen. I had to be wrapped up, drugged up. I played exceptionally well under the circumstances, but once all of those things wore off, pain came back. So arthritis, inflammation of the joint. Now, let's find out, based on these laws, Yolanda, what produces that problem? Let's just take a couple. I'm not going to go through all of them. Let's just deal with a few. Let's start with Dr. Truss. Dr. Truss, godly Truss, is the antidote for stress. Now, stress, I'm asking this question, you can write down stress. Stress is valuable. We all have stress. You agree with that?
Yes.
Now, stress is not an enemy. Stress only becomes destructive when its intensity or duration, that's the strength and how long it lasts, exceeds my capacity to manage it constructively. That produce anxiety, worry, and et cetera. All right? So from 1 to 10, 5 on up, meaning close to high and high, and 4 on down is low. What number will you give your stress?
9.
Okay? 9. Then you must ask yourself that question. So Yolanda, how long you been at 9?
Probably 4 or 5 years.
Okay. Now, I'm not going to get into the reason why because we don't have time, but I'm just going to show you how stress impacts arthritis. Okay, Yolanda been at 9. That's high stress. Now, the body is designed by God, built-in mechanism to deal with stress. We have what we call the fight or flight syndrome. Are you with me? And as you're driving down the road and someone run out in front of your car, that's stress. Would you say so? And so what's going to happen? Your heart, breathing. There's certain biological process that takes place. Your brain produce certain chemicals, neuropeptides that surge into your blood vessels in order for you to handle that stress. That is only what we call momentary. That's imminent. Are you following me? Because if that level of stress stayed 24 hours, 48 hours, it becomes damage in stress. Case in point, 9 for several years. Blood vessels constrict. Now remember, arthritis is inflammation of joints. Where there's not enough circulation getting into an area of the body, that produces pain. Wherever there's not enough circulation, now, you can sit down, I know you just sit down, but I still need to ask you questions now. You just sit there. If there's not enough circulation getting into that area, you're going to have pain. This is why Leviticus 17:11 says, the life of the flesh is in the blood. Minister of Healing, page 271, in order to have good health, we must have good blood, for it's the current of life It cleanses the body and it nourishes every cell. That's what the blood of Jesus does. Then it says with perfect circulation. So if there's not enough circulation getting in that area, pain. So stress constricts blood vessels. Stress produces fats into the blood. That creates toxicity. Now the immune system recognized that toxic waste, and then the immune system began to attack your tissue. That creates inflammatory reaction. Stress. We find that when we're under stress, the immune system is suppressed. I hope you understand where I'm going with this. I'm dealing with a sickness, and I'm going to the law to reveal what the problem is. Are you following me? That's what you need to do. Check yourself out. So now, stress also affects nutrients in the body, especially potassium and calcium. And if you're sitting with high blood pressure under stress that's above 5, everybody who has high blood pressure has low potassium. The doctor will give you a diuretic, flush potassium out of your body, then give you a potassium pill. And there you're sitting with stress. Stress will cause calcium to be depleted out of your body that affects your joints. Are you following me? I'm just dealing with stress. All right? Let's fast forward. Let's go down to, let's look at exercise. Exercise. Remember, circulation is important. Now, I'm going to tell you close. My only thing that was going in my favor when I had arthritis, I was an athlete. I exercised. If I did not exercise, I would have been in a wheelchair. Because you don't use it, you lose it. Again, circulation. My friend's son, when he was young, about this young, how old are you, my friend? 14. 14. He was about his age. He bought a dog, a Rottweiler. You know what a Rottweiler is. God created these dogs with tails. But a Rottweiler looked better without a tail. So my friend's son, instead of taking it to the veterinarian, he got a big rubber band. And wrapped the tail with a large, thick rubber band. Crude and rude. He probably should have been put in jail for cruelty. But he put that rubber band on the tail, left it for 3 days. It atrophied, my brother. It dropped off. He cut the circulation off. Anybody with me? So, therefore, when you don't exercise, the blood becomes stagnant. It's just like cancer. Cancer cells love to thrive in a dirty bloodstream. You can get the cancer, just like if this was cancer, this was the tumor, but the tumor has roots. In the book of Job, chapter 14, verse 7 through 9, Job 14, 7 through 9, the Bible said there's hope for a tree, though it be cut down, yet its roots wax old in the earth. At the scent of water, it shall sprout again. So you can cut a tree down, and it will sprout. That's hope. Are you following me? So if you're going to change anything, even though you remove the symptom, the effect, but you still got roots. And the very soil, as God brought man out of the dust of the ground, is the blood. In order for the body to be healthy, the blood got to be healthy. You with me so far? All right, let's move on to two more in closing. We got to exercise. Even though I'm not telling you go out there and do power walk, but every step you make. I told a group last time, I had a sister. She was a diabetic for 30 years. She weighed almost 400 pounds. She was on a walker. She couldn't walk from that wall to that wall. 30 years of diabetic, 100 units of insulin, 525 milligrams of glucophage, 7 meals a day. I'm the youngest out of 8 children. God raised me up in due season, like he probably raised you up too. I said, sis, why don't you come? Give God 18 controlled days of your life at our lifestyle center. Let's see what he can do for you. I'm going to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, within 18 days, she was diabetic free. Then after a period of time, she was walking 1 mile without a walker, which she did every day. And then she started walking. I just got through doing a lifestyle center. We just opened up a facility in Georgia. There was a lady in a wheelchair. She had lymphedema, legs that big, swollen, fluid, cradle sores. Been in a nursing home, so this person took out of the nursing home. Wasn't doing no exercise. I told this lady, I said, you know, we want to get you from the wheelchair just to the walker. She never walked. Just to get her from the wheelchair to the walker. Within 18 days, that woman was on a walker. Working with that lady, exercise. You got to exercise. Move it. If you don't move it, you'll lose it. All right, last couple. How much water do you drink? Give me 2 glasses, 4 glasses, a couple bottles. 4 glasses. Follow me. Now, I was not a water drinker. I was stressed like you. I exercised, but I didn't drink water. I like Gatorade. I was an athlete. Soft drinks. Your body, my body, 80% water. Follow me. Your brain, young man, 80% water. So when your body is dehydrated, this is what it does. It takes water, number one, from your blood. Pulls water from your blood. It thickens, that's right. Put pressure on your heart. Blood pressure goes up. It takes water from your cartilage. When I used to walk, squeak, crack, like the Tin Man, huh? It was pulling water from my joints. You got a little sac called the bursa. Little sac called the bursa. Holds a fluid called the synovial fluid. That's why you can do this. But when it become calcified, dehydrated, oh, pain. Are you with me, ladies and gentlemen? Not enough water. Not soft drink, not coffee. Every cell carries out its activity through a process called osmosis. Water. Your body's 70% water. Your kidneys, 80% water. Your blood plasma, 80% water. Your lungs, your water. You like water, man? He said it too slow there. But anyway, all right, now, this is how much water you should drink. Your body weight divided in half. Listen to me. Now, don't worry about if you weigh a lot and you want to say, I weigh a dripping 180-something pounds, maybe 85. So just say 180. 2 into 180, that's 90 ounces of water. Divide that number by 8. 8 into 90, that's roughly almost 11, 12 glasses of water a day. Now, this is 2 glasses of water. So if I had to drink 12 glasses of water, how many bottles I need to drink?
Six.
That's minimum. Because if you don't drink water, it's going to pull water from your brain, from your blood, from your joints, from your liver, from your skin, from your colon, constipation. Are you with me? All right, let's go to the last. Are you following me so far? I got a gift I'm going to give you for your courage. Last one. I'm just skipping. Anybody following what I'm doing? I'm just going through these laws. You know, I just went to trust, exercise. I mean, there's a lot more. I can ask it, but I just, because my time is out. Let's go to nutrition. You eat breakfast?
Yes.
What do you have for breakfast in the morning?
Bread.
Give me a menu. Some bread. How many slices?
Bread. Two.
Bread.
2 slices of bread. It could be margarine.
A margarine on it. What else?
Fruit.
What kind of fruit? Okay, so bread, fruit, what else?
Sometimes hot cereal.
I'm closing.
Hot cereal, like Old Bill.
So will you have that all together?
Yeah.
Okay, what will you have for lunch? I'm closing. This is my last one. Oh.
Whatever my hands find, you should.
Okay, all right. Now, this is what I'm doing. And I have a book I'm going to give you. And when we set up our table, just come to our table. And I'm going to give you this book, Taking Itis Out of Arthritis. And what I learned, number one, I used to eat a lot of flesh food before I became a Christian. I didn't know any.
I don't eat meat.
But I'm not saying. But one thing, I found that purine is in a lot of flesh food. And if you eat a lot of beans without green vegetables, you produce a lot of purine, you see. And purine produces uric acid. Uric acid binds calcium. You follow me? So anytime you eat beans and rice, you better eat a lot of green leafy vegetables with it. Are you with me? So we find What about sugar? You using sugar? I was a sugarholic. Used to eat sugar sandwiches. Sugar pulls calcium out of your joints. You with me? So simply, instead of me taking some, I need to just make some changes. I'm going to give you this book. Now, if you're in pain, if you come to my God's Pharmacy, I'll tell you how to make a very nice liniment to increase your circulation. Do you understand what I'm saying? Praise God. Did you get what I tried to do here? Do you understand? So find out which one of these doctors you need to stick with. We better have a word of prayer together. Let us kneel and have a word of prayer together. Loving Father in heaven, we thank you for being so gracious to us. We thank you for Yolanda, her willingness, but Lord, I know that you can restore her health. Give her a heart of resolve to follow your plan. Be with us all, Father, that when we share and teach others, at least we will not be a castaway. We need your grace, even to drink water, to exercise, to get up in the morning time. Father, let us realize that health in itself is not what we're looking for. We want to be in such of a state that our minds might be clear, that we can hear your voice. Keep us throughout the remaining of this day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.